Hello everyone, welcome to part 18 of SQL for Beginner series. In this video session, I am going to walk you through the different MySQL built-in functions and their categories. So, what are the different built-in functions and their categories? In SQL, we can use several built-in functions. In SQL, we can use several built-in functions. Here, when I talk about the built-in functions that we can use in the SQL statements, we have to talk about the different RDBMS software. Why we have to look into the different RDBMS software? There is a reason, guys. There is a relation between the several built-in functions that we can use in SQL and the RDBMS software. For example, MySQL. MySQL is one of the RDBMS software. There are several RDBMS software. And few examples for this, few famous RDBMS softwares are, one is MySQL RDBMS software and another one is Oracle, and there are many other RDBMS software available in the market. Let's take another one, Oracle. Oracle RDBMS software. Like that, several RDBMS softwares are there. For example, if you are using this open source and free MySQL RDBMS software, then the built-in, this MySQL has different built-in functions that we can use in the different built-in functions that we can use in the SQL statements. Similarly, if you take Oracle RDBMS software has its own built-in functions. So there are several RDBMS softwares like MySQL, Oracle, and many more. And if you take it, the built-in functions are not same across different RDBMS softwares. MySQL has its own list of the built-in functions. Oracle RDBMS software has its own list of built-in functions that we can use in the SQL. Though SQL is kind of a standard kind of statements are there in SQL, but the built-in functions that we use in the SQL will differ based on the different RDBMS software. MySQL has different built-in functions that we can use in SQL, and Oracle has its own built-in functions that we can use in the SQL. So which one we are going to choose? I cannot actually take different RDBMS software and explain built-in functions for each and every RDBMS software. That's not possible, right? So I will try my level best, but that is not possible. To get started, I am going to choose MySQL as the RDBMS software, and we are going to use the built-in functions of the MySQL. How to find out the different built-in functions of MySQL or different built-in functions of the Oracle? Simple, guys, you can Google it out. Go to google.com and Google search for MySQL built-in functions, like this. MySQL functions. So you'll get MySQL functions like this. There are several references or something is there. You can check there. So if you go here, so there are several type of functions are there. String functions are there, numeric functions are, date and time control. A lot of built-in functions are there for MySQL. Similarly, if you want to find out the built-in functions of Oracle, Oracle RDBMS software, then Oracle SQL, you have to say SQL, guys. Better to say SQL, otherwise it will give some different results. MySQL is fine, but Oracle, you have to say Oracle SQL built-in functions, so that you will get the proper results. There are different type of built-in functions in terms of the Oracle here. So listed by category, SQL functions, doc.oracle.com. Maybe this is good. Let's go here. You can see here, guys. If MySQL has different type of functions, right? Different built-in functions are there. You can, let's select string functions in MySQL. Okay, so these are the string functions that are available in the MySQL RDBMS, and these built-in functions of MySQL we can use in the SQL. Similarly, Oracle also has its own functions. For example, if you scroll down here, there are different functions, ABS. All these are functions related to built-in functions in Oracle RDBMS software, which you can use in the SQL statements. Like that, guys. Different RDBMS software has different built-in functions that we can use in the SQL statements. Okay, that's the thing. So now, for practical demonstrations in the upcoming videos, I'm going to choose MySQL as the RDBMS software. Okay, I'm going to choose one of the RDBMS software, that is MySQL, which is open source and free, so that we can easily try out all the built-in functions of the MySQL RDBMS software. So before actually I practically demonstrate in the upcoming videos, in this video session, we are going to look in the different categories of these built-in functions that are available in the MySQL RDBMS in a structural way. For example, this is a built-in function. These are MySQL built-in functions, guys. Okay, these are MySQL built-in functions. So at a high level, the built-in functions in MySQL can be categorized into these four types at a high level, guys. Okay, string functions, numeric functions. These are general functions that we can use in the SQL statements in day-to-day activities. Okay, string functions, numeric functions, data and time functions, aggregate functions. Coming to string functions, the name itself says this is a category, guys. Okay, built-in functions category of MySQL, that is string function. That means you can perform operations using these functions on the text kind of data. In tables, we have textual data. On such kind of textual data, you can perform the string functions. So upper, lower, if you want to convert some text into uppercase, you can say you can use this upper function. Similarly, length, if you want to find the length of the text, length. So concat, if you want to combine, or two texts are there, if you want to combine them into single text, then concat. Like that, many functions are there that I'm going to explain in a detailed way, in a practical way, in the upcoming videos. So these are about string functions. Similar to string functions, we have numeric functions. As the name says, these functions will work on the numbers, numerical values, right? Numerical may have decimal point or non-decimal point, whatever it is, okay, without decimal point or with decimal point, both are numeric values. Okay, so numeric functions will work on the numerical data in the tables. For example, if you want to find the greatest of the number, okay, numbers, then you can use greatest. Least of the numbers, you can use least. Like that, many other functions are there. Similarly, data and time, as the name suggests, data and time will have the functions. This particular category has the built-in functions related to data and time. So here you see current underscore date. The current date will be retrieved. Okay, current time. The current time will be retrieved. Now system data, like that, many other data and time related functions are there, which we can use in the SQL statements. Okay, these are MySQL built-in functions that we can use in SQL statements. Fine. The last category is aggregate functions. Aggregate functions are average. What is average, guys? Average of something, right? So unlike these three type of functions, okay, these three functions will work on individual data of a particular column. But here, they work across a group of data under the columns. For example, we have a table here. Okay, we have a table here. So let's not make it too complex. Let's say there is some kind of like a price column is there. Okay, price column is there. So here we have different records. Here we have different records like this. So how does the aggregate functions work? Let's say there are some numbers here. Here 5 is there, here 3 is there, here 1 is there, here 7 is there, and here 2 is there. Let's say these are different numbers. If you say average, average function can be applied across this number of values. Okay, not only single record, multiple records, you can apply the average function, this AVG function. Okay, but coming to the string, numeric functions and data and time functions, they generally work on single things. Okay, only this value or this value or this value, they will work. But aggregate functions, category functions, will work across the records, whereas string, numeric and data and time functions will work in a single record. But here multiple records can be considered for this kind of functions. So these are the four categories of MySQL built-in functions that we can use in the SQL statements, guys. String functions, numeric functions, data and time functions, and aggregate functions. So this is all about the MySQL built-in functions that we can use in the SQL statements, guys. The practical demonstration of these functions will be explained in the upcoming videos, guys. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.